Hi folks, a bit more work to do on the Land Rover today. Got home from work the other night and noticed that one of my rear tail lights was out, this one here. What had happened was the plastic bit in there disintegrated, or it sort of fell out as I took the thing apart, so I'm hoping that the two contacts haven't shorted out. This is what it should look like. Anyway, these are about, I think they were £3.50 each on paddock spares. About a fiver by the time you'd had them posted and taxed and all that. So they're not expensive, nice whip-back marked items as well. Also been out to get some new wiper blades, because my ones are starting to break up. The other problem I'm going to have a look at today is that my clutch biting point is very high. That doesn't necessarily mean your clutch plates are worn out, but it might just be that the master cylinder needs a bit of adjustment, so we'll have a look at that as well. Okay, well, that's the wiring exposed, bit of a mess in here, but I have before now had a good look and there don't appear to be any breaks or anything anywhere, so I think it is at least safe. Anyway, the lights were connected before with crimp connectors, so I'm going to use those again. These are the three wires we're using, the two lives and the earth. So I'm going to screw the new light fitting on and then we'll connect it up, see if it works. Right, well, I'm going to change the other light cluster as well, simply because I've got one to put in. Managed to get the cover off. Few seized screws and things, bolts, you know, but we got there. This one's obviously been replaced and it looks like exactly the same item that I'm about to fit, but the bulb holder itself was worn out and the bulb doesn't sit in there very nicely, so hence why I'm changing it. Not very impressed to find all this insulation tape. It looks like someone's just wrapped the wires together and then taped round, so I'll cut off before them and then use my crimp tags as well. Should be able to make a slightly better job of that. Okay, well, interestingly here we can see the original colour of this Land Rover. I've been doing a bit of digging and this one was just an off-the-shelf Land Rover bought by the MOD. So it was completely standard. Well, there's a few small things that are different, but it's pretty much standard for the sake of the argument. So it would have come out the factory in standard colours. So it's this kind of light green. And it then had this colour, olive drab, or whatever the British Army equivalent was at the time put over there. Someone's then used USAF green on it, but you can see there the original green. And also behind the light cluster, when I took that one out, I found black paint. And they often painted these a combination of black and green. So eventually I'd quite like to repaint it in the proper colours. Okay, so we now have both brake lights. So I just check it if I'm on my own. Right, just try and show you the adjustment for the clutch master cylinder. I've propped the pedal down. I just need to wind it in that way. Okay, I've adjusted the master cylinder. I've just got a torch down there, so hopefully you can see the clutch pedal well. Now, before, the clutch biting point was about there. And then you'd bring the pedal up about another 3/4 inch, and that was it. I couldn't make it slip. Last time I drove it, I was trying that. You could put your foot down hard in first and second gear, and you cannot make the clutch slip, nor in top gear, going up hills or anything. So I think that's okay, the actual plates themselves. So I've lowered the biting point a bit. Now the test here, first of all, to make sure you haven't overdone the adjustment, I've only moved the master cylinder rod about a 16th inch. but the trick is to go for reverse and make sure that it has disengaged. If it hasn't, you'll get a bit of a crunch like that. I'll put the pedal down a couple of seconds, select it easily so the gears are stopping. Same with first gear, there's no synchro on that or on second. So this should make double clutching a bit easier as well. Anyway, let me show you. The clutch starts to bite just there. It's about an inch and a half of travel. Much easier. See, the clutch is biting nicely there, as opposed to there. So I'm well pleased with that. Still love the tick-over sound of these things. A bit agricultural, but quite nice. Next job with this Land Rover is to do the front spring hanger bushes. You can just see one here on the rear springs. So I've got some decent axle stands, 3-ton axle stands, so I can get on with that. Bit of a swine to do by all accounts, but I'll take a video of it nonetheless. And yeah, so look out for that soon. Okay, well, I hope you've enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching.